Happy Saturday, everyone. I bet you this is another surprise. You weren't expecting to see this one so soon. Now, I don't have any updates on when this will be available per se. I don't have that information because I don't actually work for Round 2 Models, but they sent over the MPC Warlock. It's a 77 Dodge Warlock. Of course, we also know the two-wheel drive counterpart to this is the little red Express. So I'm hoping now that we have the Warlock reissued somewhere down the road, maybe in the next year or something, we might get to see the little red Express version of this kit. But on today's build, we're going to be building this little beauty, one of my favorite trucks that was ever built. Dodge always came out with these sport trucks and they were so much fun. This is the Warlock. It's got four-wheel drive. It's got it. Well, back then you could get it with a 440, 360. It had multiple engine options available, whereas the little red Express was just the 360 Express engine, and that was it, available in two-wheel drive. So let's take a look at all the cool stuff in here. We're going to have some awesome parts and extras in this box. We'll start looking at the white styrene molded in non-colored plastic. We can see we've got a CB radio. We've got an optional brush guard. So you can use these parts or not use them. We've got a roll cage assembly, a very large one. We've got a nice tank there. We've got our front suspension, shocks, rear suspension, differential, cylinder heads, block and transmission, water pump, fuel pump. We've got our stock manifolds on there, which makes me guess, just looking at those, it would be the 360, since this is shared with the little red, that would be a small block on there. Oil pan, intake for a single carburetor. On this parts tree, we've got our front suspension, front differential, nice little jack. We just saw that in a kit that I built on the show on Wednesday. We've got frame braces, transmission braces. We've got another set of shocks for the four-wheel drive line. We've got our drive shafts on here, transfer case. So it's cool that this one's got some spare parts in it too, a lot of neat, interesting stuff. We've got our underbody spare tire. We've got another transfer case, transmission braces, radiator, cross brace there, looks like the engine cradle, sports steering wheel, molded open and it's not flashed over. Taking care of those molds. We've got our exhaust system, firewall, radiator mount on there, and another toy in the box, a toolbox, just like I built up earlier this week with the Coronet. On the Warlocks and the little reds, they had these optional wooden bed rails. You can see them right back here. Those are always give that sweet little look to the truck. We've got another drive shaft here. It's got a nice wood grain on there. We'll be able to paint that and hand detail that. You can see the little bolts used to hold the wood together. We've got the tailgate, which can be left opening or closed. Stamped metal on the little red that's covered in wood with a little red truck logo in the back. We've got the Dodge plastic dashboard. Even has the molding for the tachometer on the side there. Then our standard round gauges. Remember when the 55 speed limit was in orange on those gauges? Got seat pads, console pads. We've got that nice big Dodge hood. My dad had the same hood on his Ramcharger, and then he had him put the engine size on these little insets here so that it looked cooler. Exhaust system and wheel backs. So you're going to have all kinds of extra parts on this kit. We've got our interior tub, which in these trucks was very basic. They were, you know, adventurer chassis. They're not super fancy. It's not like trucks nowadays where they're all decked out. Very, very basic plastic interiors, cheap vinyl seats that were the hottest seats you would ever put your skin on. You learned quickly, if you had shorts on, to bring towels. My friend's little Red Express black vinyl interior, oh my God, in the summer, you'd sit on that and they'd hear you scream for 3 miles. Got the frame and the underbody metalwork. fenders under the cab. Even has brake lines molded in though. Fuel tank inside the frame rails. Mounting locations for the axles and the springs. Spare exhaust locators. We can see on the top side the inner fenders. Looks like the inset for the battery or something on the firewall. Round for the radiator mount. I'm really excited. This came in and I was like, oh, I was so pumped up to get this. On the inside of the bed, we can see the beautiful chrome rails and the wooden bed. They had wooden beds in them with steel sides. On the little red, the steel sides were covered in wood trim that was bolted on. On the Warlocks, it was left metal. You can see all the trim around there. So you could do that with chrome trim. If you just wanted to build a Dodge stepside, you don't have to build a Warlock just because it's on the box art. A lot of people seem confused by that. They seem to think just because the box art looks like this, that for some reason they have to build the model like that. And they get all upset. Well, I wanted it to do something else. Well, then just build it as a Dodge stepside. I got a rusty green one down the road from me I could duplicate too, but I love the Warlock, so I want to do that. Nice thin cab vents. That was our air conditioning. We just turned those in reverse and it pulled in all the air. Along with, remember the vents on the floor that pulled in air from here? I don't make those anymore. None of that stuff. It's all air conditioned now for the gentles. Got our windshield wiper blades. The gentle folks, they don't like that fresh air coming in. We've got some chrome axles on the other side of the table that will support the weight of the model. Awesomely, in this edition, the wheels are molded in gold metallic. Just got to throw a clear coat, maybe a black wash in there, and your nice gold Warlock wheels are all done for you, or simply paint them over. Single cab glass, windshield and back glass, doesn't have a slider in this version. Got some accessory light. So you got some clear lenses left over. A nice set of Desert Dog PCV tires by Formula. Excellent vintage tread pattern. Lettered on both sides. And I will probably white letter mine because on the sport trucks, white letter tires just look amazing. And we've got a nice chrome tree. You can see the little red wheels if you've been waiting for those for a model. Front and rear bumpers that have Dodge molded in. We've got mirror options here and here, depending on the kind of mirrors you want to put on. The Dodge grille, headlight turn signals molded in. We've got light bar lights, air cleaner, side steps, alternator, fan. A lot of that stuff I will paint over the fan, I will. Valve covers, if you want chrome valve covers on your Warlock. And let's get to the decal sheet to round it up. This is the decal sheet. It's got all that pinstriping on there. Our Dodge logos, tailgate logo, Warlock by Dodge. In the cab, we've got the gold logos over the black dash, or you've got individual gauges if you just want to do an adventurer. Got the custom cab, Power Wagon 180 logos if you want those, 1977 plates. We've got Wisconsin license plates on this one, which is awesome. Don't see those too often. Pinstripes, the huge Warlock logo for the hood, and if you're worried about the pinstripes going on, they are one large decal for the cab striping. You can see the reflection of the halo light, that you can see that, or you could trim those out and do those. The bed ones are individual pinstripes to go around the wheel wells and all that. And that's it. That's all the stuff in this 77 Warlock edition. I am going to start gluing mine together, and I will see you all in just a moment.
Thank you.
A chill building session leads us to the point here, the sub-assembly show-off, as I've called them since way back in the day. We can take a look at the stuff we're working on, the things I will need to get paint onto. We've got that cool jack, just like I built up, and the toolbox. This is a little smaller than the other one, so it is a different toolbox, and I think the jack might be a little smaller, but don't quote me on that. It's probably the exact same size on that one. We've got our steering wheel ready to go. I leave a lot of stuff on the parts trees so I can get them painted. Then I will snip them off and just touch up the paint really quick with some matching craft paint, and we don't have any problems with that. The nice exhaust system goes together into two large pieces. This Warlock will have dual exhaust off of its engine instead of a single exhaust system, and that can be routed. The differentials, being a four-wheel drive and everything, sit high enough that we'll be able to get this routed underneath and through. Worst case scenario, when I've built these before, because this has a right and left exhaust system, as you can see, to come out the back, is that when it goes under the axle, you can simply cut it right before that pin there, put it into position, and then drop a super glue will hold it together. And because it's underneath the axle, you never see that. You really would have to look close to notice it. If you're going to a model show, obviously, probably wouldn't do that. On your shelf, if someone's turning over your models and trying to see if they can find a little tiny split in the exhaust, just take this part like this, you put your fingers in that, and you pop them in the side of the ear like that. They'll stop doing it right away. It's amazing how fast it works. So we've got those together with the exhaust, and then we've got the belt and pulley system. I don't remember the little red having a chrome fan and clutch and a chrome power steering pump. So I'm going to be painting over all of that. We're not using the front suspension and shocks. That's going to be, hopefully, I'm going to keep saying it, hopefully, if they reissue the little red, the two-wheel drive version. We've got a drive shaft on there. We've got our bed sides. We've got the wheel backs. The wheel backs I'm going to paint black so that we can see the open spokes of those beautiful gold wheels like we see here and there. I want them to look black through that like they would through the real thing as we look through it, because, you know, behind that you're going to see a disc in the front and a drum in the back, but we'll just leave it black. We've got this put together. Like I said, the way these look to me, I'm just going to say it's a 360 in this because I know it's from the little red, and I Googled what the Warlock engines look like, and they're the blue, and the valve covers are blue too. They weren't chrome. So I glued all that on there. The carburetor I'll paint separate. We've got our little distributor on there, the hole for the radiator line, and it makes into a nice engine. They even include a filler piece, and you could fill this in with putty if you wanted to go that far, for the models where the steel axle doesn't go through the oil pan. So you fill that right in. That's part number 29 in the instructions they show you, and that just quickens it up and makes it look pretty cool. The body needed no work. All I did was go and wash it with Simple Green. You can use dish soap, any of that stuff, to get any mold release off there, but it doesn't need any work at all aside from that. Neither does the dashboard. This is a front body panel that actually goes in under the grill down there. So I'll want to make sure I paint that body color, which on this Warlock, is going to be black. Tailgate, dashboard, they're all going to be black, the simple black interior. On our interior tub, I did the seat padding for the center console and then glued the firewall in place. Very simple paint concept on this truck. I mean, it's a black Warlock with a black interior. And we're going to be using pretty much one can of spray paint. On the chassis itself, I did glue the transfer case in just so I have a point to work from for my drive shafts to snap them. You have to kind of curve them a little bit and snap them in place. And because this transfer case sticks out so much, I can easily paint that. We've got our cross members. We've got our differentials front with the steering you can see built in. Rear, got the shock absorbers in. Got the springs on the front and rear. And got the shocks on the front as well. Goes together without a big fight, not a problem. The springs aren't even like directional or built on the sides. They have the exact same part number. It's weird. So I just write the part numbers down, start gluing it all together. I like to use Plastruct bonding model cement. I'll show you the bottle here. A lot of you ask. I get this from modelroundup.com. This version of Plastruct, just it goes right through instantly and holds tight. Very excellent glue. Although all the modern glues, Tamiya Ultra Thin, Tamiya Regular, the Revell glue in the tube, this stuff actually works really well. It's just thicker. But this I got from Revell USA. It works very well. Any of the Testers liquid cements work well. The Testers tube stuff I don't like personally, but you know, it will work, but the Testers brush-on liquid cement works very well, so if you're wondering about any of that stuff. Then I've got the radiator mount and the radiator, which mount in two different locations on this truck. The radiator mount is forward. The radiator itself is just hanging off the front part of the chassis, so I'll be able to drop that engine in there once I get it painted and deal with it. So speaking of paint, that's where I'm going to take all these parts over right now. We'll be right back. Yep, it's already time. Start taking a look at all the work I've put into this truck, and it's a good amount of work because you've got to do some detailing. Even though it's a black on black truck, there's still a significant amount. And now that I've done this in black, I'm kind of bummed out that I went online to look at something that I needed to check and saw that there was a really cool dark green one with the gold stripes. But anyways, hey, that's the way it is. Now, on the hood, you can see I just did the ring of pinstriping decals. I cut out the demon. It's not for me. I didn't want it on the hood of my truck. Obviously you can do that if you want, but I sliced it out and removed it. Laid the decals on there. We can see how nice that black paint is already glossing with a coat of clear floor polish. It's going to be just wonderful. So we can see that looks great on there. All of that. Didn't need to do any trim. It's got black rubber trim, black vent trim on this one. So I just did the door handles, which are metal. Did the windshield wipers, which are bare metal or aluminum or whatever they had them. And we are set with the cab. Looks wonderful. Just needs to be installed. The interior, the decal laid down nicely with some of that decal solvent. I did the spokes on the steering wheel. Got our shift levers in there. Transmission and transfer case. Glossed up the seats and did just a teeny tiny bit of door panel work with the latch and the window crank. That's it. Again, another easy thing to do on a black on black truck. We got the flat black carpeting, and then I just glossed the seats and the parts of the door panels. You saw a couple different ways how to do wood on a truck for the bed rails that were up higher. I want all the wood on this truck to be glossed because it was polished with a varnish. Use some Tamiya clear orange for the accents on the straight up and down bed rails. Those turn out lovely, and then sealed that. Got the decals on the tailgate. They look lovely. Got our grill done and the lower trim glued in place. They didn't have really clear yellow, orange turn signals, but I like them, so I stuck them on there for the marker lights. Did the Mod Podge on the headlights. Not as good as a plastic headlight, but we make do. And then you saw different uses of black craft paint and black wash to fill those parts in on the grill. Make the grill look nice. How about these wheels? The wheels look delicious. We got a black wash inside, and we got the black letters, and then I flat coated the tires instead of sanding them. Seals in those white letters. Those are going to look sweet. I've got the wheel backs on the axles already, and then these will just press over and friction fit, and we'll have a nice black behind the wheels on there. The bed is done with our chrome rails, our paint. I used future floor polish because I wanted to brush it in. I didn't want to have to mask all this off and spray that with a clear like I could the bed rails. So I just used future floor polish. Gives me that same shine. Goes on easy, dries nice. Once that was dry, then I did all the bed strips. And it looks wonderful. It looks nice. So we got all that ready to go. The chassis itself. We've got that engine under the hood. Call it a 360, call it a 440. I've seen a whole bunch of the Warlocks in four-wheel drive with the 440. Maybe that was the only engine they could have. I'm sure many of you will scream in the comments. You'd like to do that, so that's cool. Doesn't matter to me. It's a V8, we know that. Got our battery, got our radiator mounted. Underneath, we've got our exhaust mounted up, our drive shafts, our spare tire, all the way out the back, and everything's painted, transfer case, all the drive shafts fit, everything's installed. Did a little dry brushing, did the rubbed bronze on the chassis just because being a black on black on black truck, it is still a dark tone, but it's not as black as the rest of the vehicle. I wanted it to stand out a little bit. The jack is done. The toolbox is done. This is the only time you're going to see them. Not putting them in the bed. Wouldn't want that. What I have to do on the truck when I'm done is attach the mirrors, the air cleaner, the side steps, the bumpers. I am likely not going to use these side mirror stands. I don't like them. Even though it's on the box art that way, when my buddy had the little red, they have the sport mirrors on it. And so I'm just going to try to attach just the post and leave a much smaller mirror look. Even though the glass is the same, it just doesn't stick way out from the side of the truck. I have to put the decals on, much like the hood decal. I've removed the massive clear carrier in the center. And I can apply these to the cab. These will go around the bed. We'll put our cab logos on it. And I will coat everything with future floor polish when that is done and reveal the final. All right, my lovelies, look at that beauty in black. If I could afford licensed music, if I had 20 grand just to blow on music for a video, I would run this outro to Back in Black by AC/DC, because that's what this beauty is. This is the gorgeous 1/25th scale Warlock from 1977, built by Dodge. The model is brought to you by Round 2 Models with the MPC branding in the vintage box art. It's got the full set of decals you see here and more. We went over those in the parts review. You can see that I slid out the Demon logo for the hood because I didn't want it on mine. And I cut out most of the clear carrier, which was necessary for at least here because the stripe has to go over the top of the door handle as we see on the real thing. So, at a minimum, you're going to have to cut out the top corner of that clear carrier. The fender stripes went on lovely. The bed stripes, the wood in the bed looks extremely realistic. The grill looks awesome. We could always use some plastic headlights in that. But if you use a little Mod Podge on there, do a lot of black washing and some black paint, it's going to look great. I did alter the mirrors on mine. I would have wanted more of the sport mirror instead of the trailer mirror, even though it's a 4x4. I still would have wanted the lower profile mirrors on the side because you're getting the same size glass. You just don't have this big arm sticking it out. And you can always just turn the mirror out a little bit when you're pulling a trailer. The side steps glue on easily. The bumpers go on. The little tail lights are a little difficult to stick on there. The front bumper, you kind of got to hold in place to get it to glue on. It's an older MPC kit. That's just the way it goes. But the chassis builds up beautifully. The wheels are awesome. The tires with their white letters, if you're going to decorate the white letters, just like the box art, really set the model off. And I said that wood bed, just when you look down in there with the wood side rails, yeah. Some of my favorite trucks. When I win the lottery someday or work my way to a rich man, I will have a Warlock just like this in my garage, parked right next to a 78 Little Red Express. So I think, hopefully, this is the 77 Warlock. Hopefully we'll see the first series, the 78 Little Red Express with the round headlights. 79s, they changed. So why not? I definitely think we should. And hopefully they'll do that. And I can build that up and put these next to each other. I don't have room to display a lot of models. But this one I'm going to be keeping and displaying in the hopes that the Little Red can come out. I'll build that, put them in a display case next to each other as Dodge late 70s sport trucks. So easy to work on kit. There's not a lot of parts to it. The final fit, the box just sits flat on that chassis slab and pushes all the way forward into the little corners so that the bumper can slide in right beneath the bed and wedge it in properly. The cab does the same thing. The back end of the cab just sits flat on that chassis. Line up your engine and your front wheel well and with the radiator, and you'll know you have it in the right position. That's as simple as it is to put it together at the end. The front grille is just glued on the sides and then pushed into place. Thick super glue to hold the side steps on. Hold it in place, let it dry. Same with the mirrors, hold it in place, let it dry. And then a coat of future floor polish. That black from Revell was already super shiny, you saw in the video. The floor polish just makes it look like I sprayed it with that 2K clear stuff that I've never used because it's super toxic. But yeah, it's beautiful. Love the kit. Enjoyed it. This is one of my favorite ones. We're starting off 2024 really good. Can't wait to see what other things you guys are going to see from me coming up. It's going to be so much fun. I want to thank Round 2 Models, all my cool peeps over there, and all the guys and the videos and the offices and the ladies over there and everything. Thanks a lot for sending this over early. Let me take a look at it. I will throw the pre-order links in the description as soon as they are available. And I want to thank all of you for watching. Enjoy the rest of your week. And we'll see you at the next review.